Hello everybody, my name is Ramon Yeni from Yeni Science, and in this video we're going to do a cyclic ForceTech setup with our motor, and everything is being controlled with a back of PLC. So what I have here is I have a linear motor, the ELAX, I have our CNAX servo drive with a bus module for EtherCAT on it, as well as a back of PLC which is connected over EtherCAT. So the first thing you need to do is you need to install the axis. You see the video right away before you do this, as well as having TwinCAT installed on your PC. After that, you're going to need to download something from our webpage. What you want to do is go to our webpage, go to download, make sure you have a login with us. Then you go to CNAX Servo Controller, and then we're going to download the firmware update package, as well as under bus module, the EtherCAT TwinCAT libraries and XML files. I've already downloaded this one, so we can straight up go into the TwinCAT. Here, the first thing we do is we're going to open the demo project, file, open, open solution from archive. We're going to our folder, EtherCAT TwinCAT, NCPTP, example project, cyclic project. We're going to do a cyclic one, and we're going to do a ForceTech basic project here. We open that up, and then we say where we want to start it. So while this is opening, we can start and install our XML files. You find that on the firmware update package download, firmware bus module. Then you go multi-protocol, that's what we have installed here, EtherCAT, and you're going to copy those XML files. Then you're going to your install folder of your TwinCAT, you're going to 3.1, then you go into config, IOs, and then into EtherCAT. And here you place them in. So the important right now is what you do is that you load them into the TwinCAT, so you go to TwinCAT, EtherCAT device, and do the reload device description so the system knows the XML files of our CNAX. After that, we're going to install the library. Therefore, you go to library, PLC library, and then you're going to install it. Once again, this is in the downloaded files, EtherCAT TwinCAT, NCPTP, and here you find the library. You open this one up, it will be installed, you'll see it here, and then you can close it. After that, we're going to choose our target system, our PLC, going here. You see it in green, it's already connected, and we're going to connect to it. And then after that, we're going to set the system into the configuration mode. You could either click here directly on the symbol, or you go to TwinCAT and say restart in configuration mode. So now here on the demo project, on the left side, you see the devices. What we're going to do is, as it's preset, we're going to save the drive because all the links of the PDOs are already done. So later on, we don't have to do it manually. If you want to do it manually by hand, you'll find every step by step on your manual as well. So we're going to save it, and then we're going to delete the whole device. Yes. And after that, we're going to scan for new ones, and it will find the whole system we have here. Very important, we just wanted to scan for the EtherCAT files. Scan for boxes, yes. Here, cancel it, and we don't want to run it. So now, we're going to once again remove our CNAX from it, which we loaded, and then we're going to add in the ones we stored before, which has all the links in, so we don't have to do that. Here, important, say yes, reconnect imported links. So after we've done that, you need to go to your real time, double click on it, and read the values from the target. Here it wouldn't be necessary, but if you have a first time PLC with your CNAX, you should do that always. And then we can go and build our solution. So we go to build, rebuild the solution. Now everything gets downloaded. The program, the example program we have, gets downloaded. That looks so far so good. Everything's there. And now we need to activate the configuration. All right, restart automatically. So now what it does, the whole program should be started. And after that, the axis should start moving. Yes, we want to have it in run mode. So now you see, it did the little reference mode or a home run. And now what it does is the force calibration. We have a force application here. So it measures everything, force tech basic. And now it starts moving in a cyclic motion with a 1 millisecond cycle. And it's force sensitive. So what it does, if it moves and feels a force, for example, my thumb here, it just reaches a limit force and starts to moving back. All this is done in the program, in the main program. So now, if you have your system running, what you could do is add on some more devices, if you have a 3, 4, or whatever access system, or you could also go into the main and start manipulating it so that you can do your real program. With this done, you have the basic setup, we have a cyclic motion, we have force tech included, and everything is running. Thank you very much, and see you next time.